When you plan to make a supersonic jetliner in the 21st century, you may think that engine makers will be falling over themselves to be part of a new chapter in aviation history. Or not. Boom Supersonic, which recently took its Overture to a four-engine design, was not that long ago jilted by its initial engine partner, Rolls-Royce. Subsequently, three other engine manufacturers stated they were not too keen on collaborating with Boom, and neither, it would seem, is Pratt & Whitney. While the president of Pratt & Whitney Commercial Engines did not specifically say the company was not interested in collaborating with Boom, he also stated that it is 100% focused on existing projects, which do not include engines for the Overture. According to Forbes, Pratt & Whitney Commercial Engines President Rick Dearlew described Boom Supersonic as a, quote, "very interesting business model with good interest from airlines," adding, "I think there is something there. We think it's an interesting business. We have conversations. I'm not aware of anybody telling them we're not interested." However, that's not a very binding statement, and perhaps of more consequence are Dearlew's subsequent comments saying, "We are 100% focused on existing programs. We see the narrow-body market as a real opportunity. We have a 10,000 engine backlog for the GTF engine model." Pratt & Whitney Chief Sustainability Officer Graham Webb has previously been quoted as saying there would be, quote-unquote, efficiency concerns regarding a supersonic engine. And while Boom might say it intends to be able to operate on 100% SAF, given that the amount of sustainable fuel will hardly be enough to go around for regular airliners, it isn't easy to justify why a supersonic plane that requires more fuel to operate should be allowed to guzzle so much of it. Boom has indeed secured some high-profile airline orders, including 20 units from American Airlines, for which the airline has paid a non-refundable deposit, and 15 for United, with options for another 35. However, when the substantial order from United came in, the aircraft had both fewer engines and a reputable top three engine partner to build them. Meanwhile, Boom stated recently that it is confident it will find an engine partner by the end of 2022. A spokesperson stated, "Some of the recent speculation we've seen related to our future engine program mischaracterizes the current situation. And while we won't comment on active partner discussions, we can confirm that Boom is currently engaged with a number of partners on Overture's innovative propulsion solution. We remain on track for our engine announcement before the end of the year." Boom's engine woes began last month when Rolls-Royce pulled out of the partnership, stating that, "After careful consideration, Rolls-Royce has determined that the commercial aviation supersonic market is not currently a priority for us and, therefore, will not pursue further work on the program at this time." Shortly thereafter, potential suppliers GE Aviation, Honeywell and Safran Aircraft Engines also reported no interest in supplying engines for Boom. Thus, we shall have to wait and see who the supersonic hopeful will turn to next. What are your thoughts on the current state of this project? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.